Criminal masterminds of Reddit. What is the worst crime you've gotten away with? In 1977, I stole a pack of fruit stripe gum while at the grocery store with my mother. When my mother saw me with it in the car on my way home, I obscured my crime by claiming I found it in the basket we used for our gloves and mittens in my kindergarten class. What a fool. She was no match for my diabolical wit. Not a major crime, but it's interesting to me. When I was 18, 32 now, I got arrested for shoplifting at a hardware store. I was into drugs, broke, needed money, so I was taking things to return later for cash. They let you do that at the time without a receipt. I got caught stuffing items behind my belt by an off-duty cop who was in the aisle next to me looking through the cracks. As I walked out of the store, security nabbed me and more cops came. Cops had me standing with my hands on a table by the main entrance while they talked to the manager. They had already discovered about $40 worth of items I had taken, but when they were asking me to unload the items, I unloaded all but one. A $200 thermostat or something. Anyway, as I was standing there at the table with the whole store watching me from behind, I very discreetly reached over and pulled it out of my belt, stuck it between my thighs, and wiggled it slowly down my legs all the way to my feet and kicked it off to the side. Somehow, nobody saw it. That little feat was the difference between a Class C misdemeanor, theft under $50, and a Class B, a difference of about $2,000 in fines and up to 6 months of jail time, not to mention lawyer fees. Spent a few hours in city jail, got bailed out by my girlfriend, and it never went on my record. Smoked pot while downloading a movie, all while drinking a beer within view of my open window. Also, I pee outside sometimes when it's dark and no one's around. This one is a little bigger than the stole packs of gum posts. Am I proud I got away with it? A little, yeah. Would I have been ducked had I been caught? Ha, yeah. I was enrolled at a university and worked for them as well. A benefit of employment was they paid my tuition. Everything was great for about a year and a half. Then boom, the area I worked in at the university was bought by an outside organization. Lucky for me, the school agreed to grandfather me in and continue to offer me free tuition. However, the paperwork had to be done differently. Instead of just applying tuition cost to the accounting books for an employee, they now had to have the school bill slash invoice the tuition to me. I would submit the invoice to administration and they would cut me a check, and then I used the check to pay the bill. Well, before a spring semester I decided that I wanted to pursue something that would not allow me to continue my education for some time, so I took it off. At the same time I was living by myself and finances were really tight, got into some major CC debt. So I concocted a plan to forge an old fall invoice from my school. The school's invoice was very basic because they created it specifically for the employee slash students in my department. Simple Word document. I simply changed the dates and submitted it. A few weeks later I have a check from the school for $3,000. Instead of using it to pay the university for classes that I never took, I used it to live on for the next few months. Me and three buddies were pulling a senior prank in high school. We snuck out to the parking lot and were removing all of the license plates from the underclassmen and administrators' cars. Our plan was to take everybody's license plate off except for seniors, and throw them all in a pile at the front of the lot. We were doing pretty well when one of the basketball coaches happens to walk out and see heads bobbing between cars. I heard him scream, and I dove under a truck. All three of my buddies got caught and had to spend 2 weeks in alternative school while I got away scot-free. That was the beginning and end of my criminal career. If you were truly a mastermind, you would have waited until everything quieted down and your friends had been caught, then continue the prank. They'd never know, and your friends could even have a chance to say they had nothing to do with it, depending on circumstances. I once stole $16 in change over the course of 2 weeks to pay for a RuneScape membership. I was about 7 years old and had my first pocket knife. I got this knife from my grandpa. This however got nothing to do with the story. Well, me and my best friend Karen at that time were outside playing in the early winter in northern Germany. It gets dark at around 5 to 6 p.m., and we were still outside, since we had holidays. However, we were so bored and decided to do something. I am the mastermind of our criminal duo who wanted to do some bad things. Karen was just the really cute girl and my best friend at that time. So we went around the block to the pub where all the bicycles stand outside while the owners of the bicycles are inside the pub drinking. I take out my pocket knife and put it into the first tire of the bicycle. Poof, what a wonderful sound. I stabbed every bike in the bike parking lot and took Karen with me, and run. We ran as fast as we could. To this day I think it's in the top 3 of the unsolved mysteries in Germany, the tire slash from 1996. Taken from my post in the most disgusting thing you have ever done thread, I'm sure this is some sort of crime. Apologies in advance for this being long. We have a big outdoor music festival here every year that is in a large park downtown. They also shut down the streets around it as well as use the civic center right by the park. When I was 17 we went my then girlfriend, and I did every year. Well, it was the last day of the event, and it was coming to an end on Sunday night. As we were sitting in front of the stage for one of the last acts, I get the ever so dreadful churning and gurgling in my stomach that I always know is going to end in diarrhea. The Porto Potters are about football field away, and they always had long lines, so I decide to tough it out since I was about to head home. It progressed further to the point that I'm starting to sweat and getting sharp pains as we begin packing up and walking out. I have to walk about 4 blocks over to a parking garage where I and they, her family, are parked. So we get there, I'm clinching trying to hold it together, and she is doing the usual drawn out teenage goodbye which feels like eternity. Finally she leaves, and I head up to the middle deck, about 3 floors up, they were on the bottom, to my car. As I walk toward my car she calls my phone and informs me she has my keys still, were in her purse, and to come back down and get them. Now, at this point it has rapidly progressed to the point I am penguin walking around this parking garage about to lose the good fight. I get back down and get my keys, she draws out the I love you, I'll miss you, blah 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 again, and I'm about to just run away. She leaves, and I think maybe I can get back in and just hold it till I get to the Porto Potty. No dice, since the event was over, they wouldn't let anyone back in. I make it back to the garage, dripping buckets of sweat, having to stop every 10 feet or so to clinch and wait for the all temporary clear. There is no public elevator in this garage, so I'm between floors, in the stairwell, when it's game time. Nothing could hold it back. It was if someone had kicked me in the stomach and there was no holding back. I fling my pants boxers off, and the most horrible chunky liquid spews out. There is so much of it that it starts running down the stairs and all of a sudden, click-chi, the door on the bottom floor, 2 flights of stairs below me, open. I quickly wipe my bottom with my boxers and throw my pants back on. As I'm entering my floor's door I hear, oh my ducking god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, what the duck. I hop in my car and take off. Flash forward to the next day. We are sitting around watching TV, and they run a news story about the event. Apparently the doorway I lost it at was also the floor that has the entrance to the mayor's office. They are looking for the vandals, and there may be a reward for any information. At this point, being 17, I'm freaking out thinking what if cameras saw me, what if they saw my car and start questioning people, what if they DNA test the poo. My girlfriend is utterly disgusted at the story and thinks people like that should be put down. A few days later, I get a call from the police department that I need to come down to the station. I'm of course freaking out, immediately turn pale white according to my mom. We make it down to the station, and I am at the point of being in tears thinking I'm going to jail. Turns out they had recovered my stolen car stereo that was stolen a few months back. They just needed me to sign off on it. 15 years ago I worked as a bike messenger in mid-sized city in the south. It was great to ride every day, kept me in shape, yada yada yada. Rode the same route downtown in said city every day, starting around 8 a.m. Riding in the same way, going to the same spots over and over, I developed a pattern, and began to notice the patterns around me. There was a bank on my route that had cash delivered every Wednesday morning, in preparation for the weekend. The driver guard would load coins on the bottom of a hand truck dolly, Stack plastic bags of cash on top of the coins and walk the money into the bank between 9 to 9:15. I got fired from my delivery job. Yada yada yada. I no longer work downtown riding my bike. I still, however, know the patterns. There was an event in town 3 or 3 weeks after my dismissal. It occurred to me that in preparation for the event, the bank would need more cash on hand than normal. This would be a great time to just ride by and steal one of those plastic bags of money, I said to myself. How do I get away though? My grandfather was fond of saying that one should do one's dirt solo, because one will never snitch upon oneself. I took this to heart. I called my cousin Tuesday night, promised him $100 to meet me at a specific location at 9:30 the next morning, and if I hadn't shown up by 10 to leave, $100 for 30 minutes of time. Who, aside from a high-end escort, is going to pass that up? I waited, with coffee, 3 blocks away for the armored truck to show up. I watched the guard load the coins and several bags of cash onto the hand truck, and just at the perfect moment, blazed up the street on the bike. I had a cap and sunglasses on, rode a stolen bike, and got one of the bags. The guard got a look at me. He was looking right at me, but I didn't break stride on the bike. One fell swoop, like a bird picking a fish from the water. It was so clean I get chills just thinking about it. I was 2 blocks away before anyone but the guard and driver of the truck knew what happened. My cousin was waiting for me. I ditched the bike, got into his car, and he brought me to another bank, where I got him his $100, and then he brought me home. No violence, no guns, no threats. $88,000 minus $100. I steal towels every time I go to Lifetime Fitness. Probably 2 towels every time I go. So far I have about 52 towels. I have no need for any of them. I just like having extra towels. Also, in high school I would take $5 from the school store register when I worked there. I used to work at a Target where I would eat and take pies all day long. I'm a klepto and I have a problem. Stealing over $2,000, now that I think about it, in books, including a moral philosophy book. Edit, wow, that blew up. I'm actually very opposed to theft, despite my corrupt past. When you steal, you think you're stealing from the big mean corporations, but you're really not. You see, they have ways of protecting their profits by socializing their losses, like blaming it on the lowest worker on the ladder, and the person who's in charge of inventory will get their ass handed to them. A friend of mine was a cashier at her campus bookstore and was friends with the inventory person and some people who stole books. When that time of semester nears, the inventory person routinely gets nervous because they have to be the mean guy stopping theft. When you're struggling for money and dealing with classes, you don't want to bear that burden. After one particularly big steal, my friend's friend broke down and cried because she thought she was going to get fired. She didn't, but it often comes out of her pocket when she can't do her job. After that, my friend tried to tell her stealing friends that what they did wasn't cool, but they were angsty college freshmen and couldn't have it, so she distanced herself from these assholes. Please think about what you do before you stick it to the man. Oh, and that moral philosophy book was A Theory of Justice by John Rawls. It's a good read, I recommend it. I once broke someone's jaw in a drunken fight. The sound that it made still haunts me till this day. I fled the scene, and have never faced any legal consequences. However, I did see a grainy CCTV photo of myself in the paper the next week. I'm in no way proud of what I done, or getting away with it, but you can't change the past.